From biggest tractor to the longest blender, here are the few most advanced agriculture machines. The scale and efficiency of these machines will blow your mind. So let's get started. A typical lawnmower is sufficient to trim grass from a yard. But when you have hectares of unwanted plants and weed, you need something bigger. Meet Oxbow 4334. It is a self-propelled merger which could clear miles of weed in just few hours. The 40 feet wide rolling blade not only cuts the grass, but throws it on the side, so it could be easily picked up by another machine. Moreover, the blade is foldable and divided into three sections, which makes it highly mobile and easy to maneuver. This machine is called round baler. As name indicates, it is used to make large round bales of hay or grass. It must be attached to a tractor as it is powered by the drive shaft. Grass is pulled inside by the powerful rotating blades at the bottom, while the revolving belts inside keep rolling and compressing the grass into round shape until the bale is formed. Upon reaching the maximum size, the hatch opens up and the bale is rolled out. These bales are then picked up by the Tenco 1320. Tenco 1320 is a wonderful machine, which is used to wrap grass bales. Unlike round baler, it could be attached to any machine that has an extended drive shaft. The arms of Tenco 1320 extend sideways to pick and hold the bale, while rotating forks wrap it with the plastic film. Upon completion, sharp blades trim plastic film and bales are placed onto the ground. Bales makes it easier to transport tons of forage and store it in a comparatively smaller area. Wrapping also protects them from rain and moisture. There are other variants of this machine, but Tenco 1320 is most popular among the farmers due to its compact size. Big Bud 747 is the biggest and most powerful tractor in the world. The tractor is so powerful that it could throw a Bugatti into shame. With 1200 horsepower, this tractor alone is equal to 10 ordinary tractors. The height is 14 feet, and attached to its back are 21 plowing attachments, which cover the area of 85 feet. It could plow 1 hectare every 2 minutes. Yes, you heard that right. At 1.5 liters, each cylinder of its engine is bigger than the entire engine of a small car. The total displacement of its engine? 24.2 liters. To provide maximum traction and withstand heavy workloads, 3 tires are attached to every single axle. The width of each tire is 8 feet. Should we even place its name on a tractor list? Maybe yes. This is AUR4. Such machines are used to make ridges into the fields. The drums at the rear are casted with aluminium alloy, so they can withstand any wear and tear in case they hit a rock or any hard object. The formation of these ridges is smoother and uniform compared to the ones created in conventional ways. Water flows effortlessly between these ridges and crops get equal supply, resulting in higher yields. Plastic mulcher. One can say that this plastic mulcher is an upgraded version of AUR4. However, it not only creates smooth ridges, but also wraps them in plastic film. In addition, it punches a hole into the plastic wrap and sows seed into the ground. Plastic mulching is mandatory for certain crops that should not be irrigated directly. Mulching locks the moisture into the soil, providing much more favorable conditions for plant growth. This is Rock King 9600. As name suggests, the sole purpose of this attachment is to remove rocks from fields. 3 rotating blades at the front picks up rock and collects them in a large bucket behind. The size of the stones does not matter, because there is a size difference between the teeth of the hull at the bottom and teeth on the rotating blades. Rock King 9600 works flawlessly, and to unload rocks, the bucket is flipped with the help of powerful hydraulic shocks installed at the rear of machine. Mobiliar Gull Mixer. This machine is just like a blender found in every home's kitchen. The only difference is its massive footprint. Equipped with a 37-meter long arm, this machine is used to make biogas slurry. What is biogas slurry, you may ask? Well, the paste-like mixture of dung and certain chemicals is called biogas slurry. To make this paste and produce biogas, it is very important to blend the dung and other chemicals properly. For this purpose, a blender is attached at the end of this arm, which is operated by a remote controller. The blender could reach the maximum depth of the container to make the perfect slurry. Moreover, the foldable arm makes it highly mobile, which means it could be driven to the remote sites. Trimming and pruning is an essential part of gardening, but trimming hundreds of plants with same accuracy could become a challenge. In this situation, Rapten could prove to be a much-needed helping hand. Rapten is a plant trimming machine, which is used to trim plants specifically in round shape. The machine could run on either fuel or electricity. Blades could be adjusted to accommodate larger plants, and operating this machine is painless, thanks to its small size. Modelo 500 LSA is a giant water pump that could be attached to the tractor to pump water from canals into the fields. The Modelo 500 is so powerful that at its maximum speed, it could pump 750 liters of water per second, irrigating vast fields in just few minutes. The diameter of pipe is 1 foot and it could rotate in any direction, which is convenient because there is no need to move tractor in order to change the direction of water. Interdrain V-Plow is a unique machine and it is one of its kind. It is used to bury water pipes without digging the soil. At the front of this machine is a V-shaped blade, which cuts through the land as it moves while laying down water pipes simultaneously. It could lay miles of water pipes in just few hours, because there is no need to dig the soil and build trenches for pipes to sit. Usually, these pipes are laid to irrigate farms which are far from canals or nearby ponds. The StrawMaster is very unique in its own ways. It is used to collect and remove unwanted straws or hay from the fields, which usually gets left behind after cultivation. The width of this attachment is 42 feet, and below this attachment are several 2 feet long iron nails. When machine moves, these nails pierce through ground. Straws or any excess get stuck on these nails. In this way, it could clean tons of filth from vast fields in just few hours. Xerion Saddle Track. The sole aspiration of this machine is to fertilize and strengthen the soil before sowing. For this purpose, fertilizer slurry is prepared and poured into its 30,000 liters tank. The slurry is spilled onto the ground with the help of a 60 feet wide attachment that has multiple nozzles. There are sensors at the tip of each nozzle, which are connected to an onboard computer. This computer performs a soil analysis and determines the quantity of slurry needs to be discharged into the soil. This machine could be used for the equal distribution of any liquid fertilizer in vast fields. Upon completion of the task, the attachment is folded onto the tanker so it could be stored or transported without hassle. Flame weeding. This is not a standalone machine, but rather an attachment to kill weed and unwanted plants. Weed could disturb the mineral concentration in a field, regardless of which crop is being cultivated, so it is important to destroy them in a timely manner. For this purpose, flame weeding attachment is used. It consists of a propane tank and multiple high-pressure flamethrowers. It could be attached to any tractor, and the pressure of flame can be regulated through a dedicated valve in the cockpit. Surprisingly, heat does not completely burn weed. It only destroys weed cell structure, which disrupt its photosynthesis abilities, and weed stops growing. Flame weeding is mostly used in corn and soybean fields.